Hi, everyone. This is a COVID-19 travel news update. I'd like to share information closer to the truth or the way that I hear things through my tourists. So this is an Airbnb apartment here downtown in Hungary, in Budapest. It's a different location than where I live, as you can see in the background. And first, I'd like to start with Australia. Anyone traveling to Australia needs a two-week quarantine. So basically, there are designated hotels where you have to pay at least $200 a night. And for each city, you have a list of hotels. And then from the airport, they basically take you, they escort you to these hotels where you have to be locked down for 2 weeks, and then you're free to go anywhere within Australia. There's a lot of restrictions in Australia, and so a minimum $200 a night. So that's what I hear about Australia. With Europe, I have some friends who've flown from Italy, from Rome to Hungary. There were 12 people on the flight. This was just yesterday. So there are flights now almost all over Europe. I wouldn't say daily flights, but what the airlines are doing. We have a budget airline called Wizz Air, Ryanair. What they're doing is they're canceling a lot of flights. So let's say they've had flights three times a week. What they'll do is they'll cancel two of those flights, and they'll put everyone pack everyone on one flight. Of course, the flights will not be packed, like 200 people. It might only be 50 people or 60 people, but they'll cancel several flights for the week, and then they'll put them together on one day, and then you'll get a notification a few days before, like I have. For example, from Malaga, I booked my tickets for Malaga, Spain, which is on the 21st of July. So they canceled the day, and they said, would you like to travel on the 20th, one day before? So they put several flights and combined it to that one day. So that's what a lot of the airlines are doing, especially the budget airlines here in Hungary, Hungary and around Europe. With Italy, what my friend told me is that people can go to restaurants in Rome, but they have to sit 1.5 meters away from each other. So you're not allowed to have lunch like four people next to each other. That's not allowed. There have to be four different tables and just one person sitting per table. In Hungary, this is very different. Hungary is one of the most open countries, I'd say. People are allowed to be holding hands next to each other. They're allowed to sit in coffee places with each other. The coffee shops, restaurants, they're open. The spas are open. So the outside spas within the entire Hungary are open. So Hungary is very liberal and very free in terms of this, which is I find great. And there are the countries that are more open with almost no restrictions are Germany, Austria, Czech Republic, Poland, Croatia. So more and more neighboring countries around Hungary are allowed to come into Hungary with no restrictions. You can come in for one day and leave and go back the next day. So there are more and more tourists booking, especially the weekends. The weekends are getting stronger and stronger. So there are tourists booking at my Airbnb flats and other hotels for these dates in July and August. So that's excellent news. I'm really happy for that. Our rates are still kind of like winter rates. So it's obviously not last year summer rates. But our rates are like half price, and they're kind of like winter rates at 38 to 45 euros per night for like three people. So, but the weekends are getting stronger. So that's really cool. Another thing with the second wave, every day I'm hearing someone about the second wave. And what I'd like to share, and I think is very important, is that we should not let the media control our lives and our happiness. Okay, so what we put our focus on becomes bigger. Okay, this is very important. And I choose not to put my focus on what if, second wave, what if. If we focus on the second wave and what we can't do, then we're just wasting energy onto something more precious and things that we can do. So I don't follow the media. I have watched the TV and I have watched the media. It's usually negative news. It has been negative news for the last 3 months. There are days now when it's a bit more positive, but I specifically don't want the media to let control us by fear. And this is very important. I don't want people, there are a lot of people who are scared, oh, what happens if this and the second wave comes and that, and it's going to be worse, what if it's worse? So if we focus on that, then this whole problem will get even worse. Because it's from one fear, it grows and grows, and it grows in the minds. It's like a seed. It will grow into the minds of other people, and that fear will grow. So I will not allow this second wave, blah blah blah, to grow in our minds. So I believe if there is a second wave at all, I will not focus on it as much. I don't care about it. Obviously, there are things within our lives and within our businesses that we have to look after. There will be always changes in the government, which we have to look and we have to watch out for. And the second thing I wanted to share is, let's just travel. Let's go on airplanes. Let's not be the ones who say, what will happen if I go on an airplane or something? What's in the air, in the air conditioned ventilation? Or what if I sit on a bus or if I sit on a train? Also ask myself and say to myself, let's just live our lives. Let's not let anyone base or anyone basically put us into a box and stay home and let us be free. Let us have lives of happiness, love, and abundance. And you can see that there are thousands of people traveling now, and they're happy. They're going back to their countries with no problems. So I've had thousands of guests over the last few months traveling as well. And it takes these first people, to these brave people, to basically to show the light that it is possible, and these are the people who are not listening to the media, not doing stay at home and be careful, and we don't want you to hurt anyone else, and look after the others and look after yourself. So let us be the ones who shine a light on others. Let us be the ones that lead by positive example. Let us be the ones that wake up and wake up with thoughts of love and abundance and positivity, as opposed to listening to the media and waking up with negative fear. News around the whole world about negative fear. Also, if you're talking about media, one of my favorite subjects is that it's interesting that there are countries, there are like Latvia, for example, or there are a few countries where there were only 300 or 200 instances with the COVID, and on a daily basis in Africa, thousands of children are dying of no food, of famine, and other sicknesses. But it's interesting. The media never mentioned this in the last 4 months. It doesn't mention it at all, very much. So it's also very interesting what the focus is on. Why the media is mentioning these things, and in these countries, why is it America? Why is it Europe? How come it doesn't really mention South America? Or how come it doesn't mention Africa? You know, where there are, especially in Africa, there are way more people dying of different diseases and no food. And we could be saving lives and focusing energy and focusing our attention on other things that kill way more people. And it's just an interesting thing that I think about time to time is the focus. So basically the focus that we put our focus on, that expands, just like I started in this video. And wherever we put our awareness, it's our choice of where we want to put our awareness. Do we want to focus on love, positivity and abundance, or do we want to focus on fear? So if anyone has any news about borders opening, closing, anything, vaccine, second wave, please write in the comments below. I'd like to share more positive info around the world, or the real news, what's happening. And thank you for watching. Please share any comments below and have a beautiful day with a warm and loving open heart. Bye.